Hi viewers, welcome back to our channel Smriti. Today we are going to talk about Bahuda River, which flooded during yesterday and today. Yesterday I shared a video where I just stepped out for some essentials and where I came to know that it's going to flow and flood for sure. But there was no any signs when I went out for essentials during yesterday evening at 6:30, but there was a little noise around and when I was crossing through that bridge. But as soon as I came back home and heard from some of localites that it started to flood at around 7:30 p.m. and that is 26th November 2020. See, this the river last night when all of them were false lit, this was flooded across on the fields since the water flow was very huge. I'm just showing in this video where all the stretches across like beside the river which been flooded, and you can understand from the video, and it pulled all the fields into the river. It flowed on to the fields and it made different paths and went across all the fields, paddy lands, and again joined somewhere else apart from the place where it spreaded. So you can view the water flow here in the video, and it was so scary, and it flooded at around 10:30 as heard from the localites. And there were no signs of any people missing or anything kind of, since the bridge was okay and the water was so more. See, this is one of the stretch which got deviated from the river and again joining back at this place. And you can view the pipelines which got moved out of the path where it's been placed, as well as so this is the place where people trying to come over here and check and take snaps and other stuff. As soon as we noticed this, it was so scary, and there were some electricity poles were broke down and trees were fully away with the water. And see how much water it is throwing. And there are few videos which I shared before, you all remember the Madhavaram waterfalls, that's the first source for this river. So yesterday morning when I verified, it's been told that it started to flood over there, and where it is not allowing people to cross the roads where it's flowing on the road. But yesterday by evening, I think Kanipakam is somewhere around 35 kilometers away from Madhavaram, but it took a day to flow through all across and reach Kanipakam. So yesterday morning we got the info that it's been floating across there near around Madhavaram village, but yesterday evening by around 7:30 it reached here. And today morning we felt to come across here and capture some of the videos. See the water in the river, how fast it is flowing, and it's so scary. Most of the people were standing and watching this side by side, either both the sides, and it's like a magic, Noah magic, because it's been 5 years this river I've been in this condition. The last time when it flowed was like 2015 November, or I think December 5th, when it's flooded in Chennai. That time it flowed actually, and again yesterday night it started to flow, and you know it damaged all the parts and plots, paddy fields and crops which are ready to harvest. Most of things got spoiled, and I do want to show some of the bridges which got broken here. And see, there is a bridge, but I think due to some small pipelines it got stuck where water was unable to go, and it made a different path at one of the side, and it pulled over onto the plots and it spoiled everything. So I think people have to look at it, where the bridge being destroyed by the water flow, and it made another part and it flew over the fields and small villages across. And we do see some sun now today, and hopefully there won't be much rain hereafter. And I heard from some of the localites that there were few domestic animals which been placed in the river been washed out when it flew last night, and there were no much damage specific to human. As heard, see, you can see the road which got vanished due to the water flow, and that is the Kandipakkam, and you are able to view the hotels and restaurants across there, and that is the temple side, and you can see the paddy fields which are flooded with the water, and sand, cements, and lot of stuff, whatever people got it for their constructions, everything been washed out. Let's see what it is going to be. And today it seems to be a slight drizzling across here in Kandipakkam, and there won't be much rain. Let's hope for the best. And if it increases, I don't think it's going to be worse for sure, because the water which flowing is will route to NTR Jalasayam. So that is near Kalavakunta. So as I explained earlier, this starts from Madhavaram forest somewhere inside, and it flew through Thavanampally mandal headquarter and Kandipakkam, and it reaches to Kalavakunta reservoir. See, this is another view from a bridge which is located nearby Kandipakkam. So as heard yesterday, the water was huge, and it was up to like half of the bridge was with the water. So, but today it looks okay. But yesterday night, there were people who were there and looking after it, were so scary whether the bridge will stand by or will it go off because of the huge water flow over there. And we do see a lot of the people coming across and viewing it, taking snaps, taking videos across. And it's muddy water because it's flowing for the first time. Hopefully, if it flows for a couple of days, then water will become clean and we can see the clear water. I will share the pics if anything once it gets cleared. And another thing, I am planning to go to reservoir Kalavakunta as well to look after, because that's been filled already a month back because of other rivers which flew from Damal Cheru and Pakala. And the gates been opened already, and the water was released since that is getting full. But now I heard like both the rivers are flowing, and probably it's been opened now, and it's going to be a good reservoir view. So, and another thing, just want to share, there is another river which is near by Airala Mandal headquarter. And that's been flooded yesterday noon, and there were few bridges which were damaged, and one bridge was been just flowed out of the place, and there is no path for people to go over that side or this side to commute. It seems to be very bad conditions due to this cyclone Noah. It has become kind of a tourist spot for visitors, where everybody is looking around, enjoying their views. And see, as I told you, it happened 5 years back, and now it's happening again, and river is flowing very good, and hope everybody is filling their ponds. As everybody know, each village will have a bigger pond where they save, they accumulate water for like groundwater levels will increase when they save some water to their ponds. So I don't have much to discuss, but I felt to share this video to you all, and this was awesome and so nice to be part of it. And but yeah, forgot to tell you, and from our house we were able to hear the water noise where it's flowing. It's huge sound from around 9 p.m. last night. But good that it didn't come up to our home. We were exactly 300 meters to 500 meters away from the river, where our paddy fields been flooded with the water already. And these are the snaps which I captured when I went across in the morning. And just please have a glance of it. It's very scary. Thank you for watching. And please subscribe and like our videos. And there are more to come. And make sure to watch the essential drive which I wrote yesterday for essential things. Thank you for watching. Subscribe and like our videos.